Hello everyone, this is Justin, an application specialist at Roctek International. Today we'll be going over how to get started in WinEx Master. If you're following along with the video, don't forget you can pause at any time to catch up. Let's head over to Drawing, select Open, head over to Sample 1, Open, and now select New Takeoff. Before we get started, we're going to spend just a moment getting familiar with the navigation controls in WinEx Master. To start, you can use the mouse wheel to zoom in and out, which corresponds to the magnifying glass with a plus and a minus. Likewise, we also have the zoom to area, which allows us to left-click, hold, and drag the mouse to zoom in. The zoom off, which allows us to zoom all the way out. And both of these items are accessible under the right-click menu. In addition to these, we have the drawing navigator in the very bottom right-hand corner, which allows us to resize the screen by left-clicking and drag, and to move the screen by left-clicking and drag. Now that we know how to move around, let's begin. Go ahead and zoom all the way out, right-click on the screen, and set scale slash start job. To begin, we'll use the dimension line of known distance for this drawing. Select OK. And you'll notice that our cursor changes to a pencil. Move to the scale. Left click one end. Left click the other. And type out the distance. From here, we'll set up our total work area. And if we wish, we can change the color and even the thickness of the line. Once these are set, you'll notice the cursor changes to a pencil. This lets us know that the left mouse button will now draw a line. The primary method of drawing a line is by either using a single left click to the beginning and end to draw a straight line, or by pressing and holding the left mouse button to start line tracker with dynamic zoom. You'll notice that I don't need to be exactly on the line. If you start to follow the wrong line, you can stop, press the backspace button, and then continue along your way. Now, let's go ahead and finish tracing the total work region. If you're interested in using one-touch imports to bring lines over instead, check out our other YouTube videos. Once we reach the end, we'll stop, head over to Finish, and bring up the job settings. Now that we have the limit of disturbance set, it's time to set up the job. To begin, we'll set a range of accepted elevations, somewhere between 0 and 35. Next, we're going to tell the software that the top 4 inches is unsuitable. So we'll select Strip Existing Surface, tap out 4, and select Done. Our takeoff is now set up, and which measurement we'll use next is completely up to you. However, if you'd like to continue with the tutorial, please allow the playlist to continue, or select the next video.